Je donne maintenant la parole.
I now give the floor to Mr. Vladimir Voronkov.
Good morning and thank you, Mr. President. First of all, I would like to thank you for giving me the floor. I am joining you from Rome, where I have just signed a memorandum of understanding with Italy's Guardia di Finanza, a major export agency and capacity building provider in the field of countering terrorism financing. To work together with the United Nations Office of Counter-Terrorism on relevant activities around the world. Today's Security Council resolution is the next evidence of France's leading role in strengthening international cooperation to counter the financing of terrorism. I would like to recall in this regard the high-level No Money for Terror conference in Paris last year, held under the personal leadership of His Excellency, the President of France, Mr. Emmanuel Macron, and where I represented the Secretary General of the United Nations. As a follow-up to the Paris conference, this year Australia is leading in convening the next international conference on countering the financing of terrorism. Mr. President, the adoption of Resolution 2462 comes at a critical time. Recent terrorist attacks around the world demonstrate that financial flows continue to reach terrorist groups from both illegal and legal means. A concerted effort to redouble the world's attention on stopping the financing of terrorism is therefore a vital topic. Several Security Council resolutions have focused on countering the financing of terrorism, but the resolution you have just adopted helps consolidate the various requirements into a single draft and expands the focus to key emerging issues, including innovative terrorist financing typologies. I would like to particularly welcome the role that the resolution assigns to the United Nations Office of Counter-Terrorism on identifying ways to suppress terrorist financing and helping countries develop the capacities to implement key priorities. We at UNOCT are ready and willing to play an enhanced role in supporting member states to implement this resolution. Mr. President, United Nations Office of Counterterrorism and its Counterterrorist Center has focused an important part of its policy, coordination and capacity building work on countering the financing of terrorism. We offer a coordination platform for interagency dialogue through our UN Global Counterterrorism Compact Working Group on countering the financing of terrorism. We have also provided practical support to member states on understanding and implementing effective measures to suppress terrorist financing. I think the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, the United States of America, Japan, Switzerland, and most recently India and the state of Qatar for making contributions to the counter-terrorist financing projects implemented by the United Nations Office of Counterterrorism. Mr. President, I would like to make 3 points on United Nations Office of Counterterrorism's priorities in the field of countering the financing of terrorism. First, we must expand our focus to include intelligence sharing, sectoral risk assessments, and public-private partnerships to ensure that financial regulation is responsive, targeted, proportional, and effective. Second, taking cue from the resolution, we must look at countering the financing of terrorism as a comprehensive package comprising a variety of related topics. System-wide awareness raising, interagency coordination, judicial reviews, and continuous commitments of human and technological resources are equally important. Human rights and humanitarian law should be upheld and protected. It's only through a comprehensive and multidimensional approach that national and international financial systems and institutions can be properly safeguarded from terrorism abuse. Third, we must work more closely with the Financial Action Task Force and FATF-style regional bodies on capacity-building assistance. I welcome the participation of the FATF at this forum. My office remains committed to working with all our partners, particularly the Counter-Terrorism Committee Executive Directorate, to coordinate capacity-building support to interested member states, which is in line with the Security Council's guidance under Resolution 2395. We will use our interagency coordination platforms to extend such alignment and assistance and needs with other key bodies, such as Analytical Support and Sanctions Monitoring Team, UNODC, IMF, World Bank, and Interpol. I would like to use this opportunity to call upon all member states, and especially those actively engaged in today's discussions, to make available national experts to UN programs on countering the financing of terrorism, so that beneficiary countries have an opportunity to learn good practices in this area. Significant financial support for more comprehensive packages of assistance is also necessary to increase member states' capacities to prevent and detect terrorism financing. Mr. President, only through strong collaboration and targeted efforts can we achieve concrete results in our fight against terrorism and terrorist financing. My office is ready to play its policy development and capacity building roles in broader international efforts on countering the financing of terrorism. I thank you very much.
Je remercie.